Hey guys, thanks for clicking over to BigNate84. Last week, I did a review of the Logitech review with Google TV. If you missed it, you can click the link in the lower right corner. In this video, I will be using the Logitech review to show you what Google TV 2.0 looks like. I'm still waiting for the Honeycomb firmware update, so what you see here will be upgraded soon to give you added functionality and easier, more intuitive navigation. While making this video, I got an email from Logitech letting me know the 3.1 Honeycomb update will automatically happen just in time for the holidays. At the heart and soul of Google TV is the Android operating system. You get the look and feel of using a smartphone on your TV. As you can see, there is a Google Chrome web browser that supports Flash, so access to all of your favorite websites will appear exactly the same as they do on your computer. In my last video, to save time, I sped up some of the web surfing shots. So in this video, everything is real time. I am currently using a very slow DSL connection. My internet speed is roughly 1 Mbps. And I'm connected through a wireless router, so that also impacts connection speed. That said, Netflix works perfectly fine for me. They have the buffering all figured out for people like me. YouTube, on the other hand, is painful to watch with my slow DSL connection. YouTube videos constantly get interrupted for buffering. That is not the fault of Google TV or the Logitech review. If I were able to upgrade my internet connection speed, my experience would be greatly enhanced. My wife and I use the Pandora application all the time. You have the ability to listen to music on Pandora while surfing the web or using another application at the same time, which I think is pretty cool. You just need to remember to turn off Pandora before starting a Netflix session. I really like the Netflix app. It allows you to easily search for movies and edit your queue. As you can see, I have the options to play, add to queue, rate this title, and adjust audio and subtitles. This is another main reason why I wanted to get Google TV. Let's say you have a computer upstairs with some pictures on it that you want to show your friends downstairs on your HD TV. Click the home button, scroll down to applications, and click on Logitech Media Player. The green laptop is already recognized under Network Sources, but if it didn't show up for some reason, I could click the Rescan Sources button at the bottom. Let's click on the green laptop. Pictures. And we'll go to Folders. And we'll go to the Pictures folder. Then 2011, then 4/9/2011, Mark and Rachel. Now I can scroll through all the pictures in that folder. A thumbnail preview will appear on the right. That's me rocking out on guitar. And let's make it a slideshow so we can sit back and watch. Let's go back to the home screen and scroll down to Spotlight. These are all the applications that have been developed for Google TV. My favorites are the NHL app, Crackle, USA Today, CNET, and TuneIn. I wish they had an NFL app. Big Patriots fan. Thanks for watching, and let me know what you think of Google TV in the comments below.